Today, we are looking at a variable type called list. A list essentially lets you remember more than one value. An example would be a list of names or a list of numbers. So, for example, I could store all the book titles of the books I own in a list. Lists in Python are enclosed in square brackets, and each value within the list is separated by a comma. Lists can contain any combination of data types, including numbers, strings, or even other lists. Let's start with a simple example. Imagine we want to store a list of names. We can do that using a list variable. Here's an example code snippet. In this case, we have a list called names that contains four elements. Each element represents a person's name, enclosed in quotes. Note that we define a list by putting the list elements in quotes, either single or double quotes, inside square brackets. We separate the elements with a comma. Lists are ordered and we can access individual elements by their index. Lists are mutable, which means we can change or update their elements. Let's take a look at an example. Suppose we want to change Charlie to David in our names list. By accessing the element at index 2, which is Charlie, we can assign a new value to it. Now, the names list will contain David instead of Charlie at index 2. We can also add new values at the end of our list. Here, you can see that Mark has now been added at the end of the list. We do this using the append function. We basically write the name of the list, then a dot, then the function append, and inside the parentheses, we write the value of the element we want to add to our list. If we want to delete an item at a specific index, we can use the pop function. Here, you see that Alice is not in the list anymore. The pop function works just like the append function. We write the name of the list, then a dot, then pop, and in parentheses, we specify the index of the element we want to remove. By the way, if you leave the parentheses empty, Python will remove the last element. There are quite a few little helpers to manage the values of lists in different ways. A few more to mention would be insert, to add a new value at a specific position, or sort, to sort a list in an ascending order. One interesting feature of lists is that we can concatenate them, just like combining strings. Let me show you an example. Suppose we have two separate lists of names and we want to combine them into a single list. By using the plus operator, we can concatenate names 1 and names 2 to create a new list called all names. Now, all names contains all the names from both names 1 and names 2 lists. Lists are incredibly useful for organizing and manipulating data in Python. Let's summarize what we just learned. Lists are a good way to store several values in one variable. We create a list by writing a variable name, followed by an equal sign, and square brackets. Inside the square brackets, we define the values our list should hold, and we separate them with commas. If our values are strings, we need to put them inside of quotes. We can access a value by writing the name of the list, followed by square brackets, and the index which indicates the position of the value we want. Remember that the first position is 0, not 1. We can also easily change values by specifying at which position we want to replace a value with a new one. Adding an element to the list can be done with the append function. Just write the name of the list and then a dot, without spaces, and append, followed by parentheses in which we specify the value we want to add to the end of the list. Removing an element from the end of the list can be done with a pop function. just write the name of the list and then a dot without spaces and pop, followed by empty parentheses. If we want to remove an element from a specific position other than the end, we can also just specify the position inside the parentheses. That's all for today. In the next lesson, we will talk about for loops, another kind of loop which is very useful for certain circumstances. See you then!